Is non-duality an escape? Recently, I was reading about the astronauts that went to the moon. Many of them experienced marriage difficulties after they returned. One of the astronauts' wives decided that to save her marriage, she would turn to Jesus and God. As a result, her marriage lasted, whilst amongst the other astronauts, there was a very high divorce rate. This story illustrates how religion can be used sort of as an escape hatch. Things are not going well in your life. You may have financial difficulties, relationship problems, a difficult teenage son. In this time of recession, job security is gone. Your savings may be at risk from the collapsing banks. You have lost hope that politicians can sort all this out. Faced with mounting problems such as these, it's understandable that you would want to escape by becoming religious. Religion promises a better life either soon or after you die. If you follow the rules set down by religion, your life will get better. Sometimes it does, as in the case of the astronaut's wife. But there are other things to turn to if you want to escape. You can try drugs, alcohol, sex, shopping, gambling, meditation, and dare I say it, even non-duality. All these things temporarily take you away from your mental or emotional pain. Yeah, non-duality can also be an escape. Many people attracted to non-duality are unhappy. Life's just not working out for them, and they turn to non-duality as a solution. How many times have I heard at non-duality meetings the question, will seeing the non-dual state make me happier? Some teachers, when they hear this question, are a bit evasive. Some downright say, no, it won't make you happy. But my short answer to this question is eventually you will. You'll feel more at ease and more relaxed about life. But before this happens, your life may get worse. You may get very confused and frightened. To explore non-duality is to find out what is really happening in your life. And you may not want to know this. If you just want to be happy, then go to a therapist. That's a much easier solution. As you discover more about non-duality, you could find that everything you believe in, everything that makes up who you think you are, is seen to be false. This is a very scary place to be. Are you prepared to have every belief, every concept, destroyed? If you get to the point of seeing through the illusion that has shaped your life, then you are definitely not escaping. You are confronting the truth of who you are. My advice to you? Give up non-duality now. Just find an easy way to live. Find a good therapist to sort your head out. Go down to the pub and talk football with your mates. Have a great girls' night out, if you're a girl. Watch soap operas on TV. Just do anything to distract you from all this questioning and seeking. If you cannot do any of the above, then welcome to the Non-Duality Club. It's going to be a bumpy ride, so hang on. It will get better. You will see.